All right, folks, I'm back for another one. I just got out of the door, and I got to wait on him. He's not done yet, so we'll do another video for you all. Now, we're going to talk about some stuff here, if we can. I'm going to think of some stuff to tell you. Anyway, how are y'all? Y'all doing all right? It's right now still about 9:30 at night, so I'll be uploading these later. You'll see them about 10:30 or 11, probably. But anyway, I'm here at this dollar store. They just built it about a couple years ago. It was really nice to have something down here in the valley where I live to actually be able to go and shop instead of having to drive 6-7 miles to go somewhere and shop. Makes it really, really handy to do, be able to do, you know. Y'all know what I mean, folks. You know what I mean. Mexican word of the day, tamale. Holy tamale, we got to go to the door. Oh, my goodness. So, I asked you earlier, what do y'all like to do? Leave it in the comments. Tell me what you like to see, what you, kind of videos you like to watch. I really would like to know. That way I know what other things to put out for you all. Give me some ideas what you want to see. And I just like to talk to you, interact with y'all. So, anyway, there was a guy down in Georgia. They finally caught him. They had to kill him. He shot two cops. Pray for the two cops down there. I think it was Georgia where it was, where it happened at. But he was out just killing people and robbing people and stuff. And the smashing grabs that's going on. People are just letting people walk in and just take what they want. And then if you defend yourself, you know, you get locked up. I don't think that's right. Do y'all think that's right? If you defend yourself, get locked up? Nah, it ain't right at all. You know, if somebody's breaking in your house and you defend yourself, you're supposed to be able to defend yourself and defend your home, defend your life, and defend your property and your family. You know, you're not supposed to be persecuted or prosecuted for sticking up for your family when somebody breaks in your house. I know a guy, guy broke in on him, two of them, and he shot and killed both of them, and then they put him up on charges for defending his own home. He got out of it, but, you know, it's bad when you go on trial for defending your life, like Kyle Rittenhouse, you know. He defended his life, and they said he was innocent. And the president and everybody was going around saying, oh, he's guilty. He's a white supremacist. No, he wasn't. He wasn't a white supremacist. You know, I don't know why everybody's right now trying to demonize the white man. White man ain't evil. We had Obama as president. So how could we be so evil if we had a colored president? We elected him. So, you know, why are they trying to say now we're so evil? And then, you know, they're trying to demonize the white man. That's what all they're doing. Everywhere you look, they're trying to push, they're trying to separate us. You know, the old saying, divide and you'll conquer. Divide and conquer. That's the oldest trick in the book. And we're going back to the days of Adolf Hitler is what they're trying to push. You know, I believe that for all my heart. They are trying to push socialism and stuff. We don't need socialism, people. Because it never works out good when the government's got their hand in all of your pockets and they're wanting from you, you know. That ain't never good. The government's saying that they know best for you. That's the 9 scariest words that you can hear is, I'm from the government and I'm here to help. I'm from the government and I'm here to help. See? 9 words. The 9 worst words. 9 scariest words you can hear is that. Ronald Reagan said that back in 1980. You know. And he was right. He was right. Sure was. I mean, Reagan might have been, I don't know, he's crooked too, probably, but no. But a lot of people like him. I liked him. I thought he was all right. I lived during his time. I was 4 years old, I think, when he got elected in. And then he was in until 89, 80 to 89, and I believe, 80 to 88. Yeah, so by the time he got out of there, I was 12. Yeah, I was 12, and I remember when George Bush got in, George Bush Sr. Then the son, W, call him W. That was the only way to distinguish the two, because they both had the same name, George Bush. And the only difference was the middle initial on the two. Because you had George Herbert Walker Bush, and then you had George W. Bush, and he just went by W. D-O-U-B-W, I believe that's how he had tags and everything with his that on it. It said D-O-U-B-W, I think. D-U-B-Y-A, I believe is how it said it. Do y'all like history stories? If y'all like history stories, let me know. I got a bunch of history stuff I could do. I could open up the history books, and I could read some stories. I've got a Sullivan County book of history stories that tell about this area I live in. What I'll do is later tonight, I'll probably read some off of that, and I'll read you some stories about the history. I've got the story of Sullivan County where I live, and it's got all them stories in it, and got pictures. I can show you pictures of those. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to do that tonight. That give me an idea. I could get that book of history out and actually show you all. So I'm going to shut this off. I'm going to call my wife. I'm going to call my wife Lisa and see if she'll get that book for me. I think it's over on the table in the living room. So I'm going to get off here for right now, and I'll be back with a story later tonight. So y'all watch for the stories, okay? If you don't catch them tonight, catch them tomorrow. But I love y'all. Y'all take care, and I'll see you, like I said, tonight or tomorrow with stories about Sullivan County. And I'm going to read to the book, and I'm going to show you some pictures, old pictures. I've got a whole big, thick book about that thick of the pictures and books and stuff of the area that I live in. It's got the Rotherwood Mansion. It's got history of the railroad. It's got the history of Kingsport, where the port come in, the Netherland in. It's got all those good stories. The Sensabaugh Tunnel's in it, I believe. It's got the history of John B. Dennis, the guy who used to live here, and he was the mayor of the town and ran the town back in the 1900s, early 1900s, and all that good stuff. So stay tuned. I'm going to put it out for you. I'm going to start doing a little bit of history, and then I'm still doing my comedy and jokes and stuff. But I think some people, I got a lot of older people that watch my channel too, about my age and a little older. So that's for you all. I'm going to do a little history and stuff like that. I know you all love it. So anyway, comment, like, and subscribe. I appreciate it when you do. I really enjoy it. I enjoy interacting with my fan base, and it helps me put out better content for you. All right? I love y'all. Y'all stay safe. All my new subscribers, all my old subscribers. Stick with me. More to come. Love you.